Hey everybody, welcome back to another garden vlog. So today I'm just going to be doing general cleanup. Today is December 2nd. So last week we got a lot of rain for Southern California. I'm talking a couple of inches, and that's a lot. So it really affected the way that my microgreens grew, how tall they grew, and I just basically had to really just cover everything up with like this tarp right here. I went to Home Depot and bought a 2-pack. It was like $17, but this plastic lasts pretty much forever. And I've got some leftover microgreens here from the week. This is all broccoli, but my seedlings are doing really good. I actually need to plant this. Some of them in the back there, they're kind of dead and flopped over. But I do need to get some of this cilantro and this dill out. And this tomato looks like it's ready to go in the ground. But I'm just gonna take you guys around and show you what I do for general cleanup. One of the big tasks I need to do today is actually to dig out some compost. So I gotta look for a container to dig out. I'm gonna dig out some. Alright, so now that I got the sweeping done, I'm just going to collect all of this plastic that I have draping everywhere, fold it up, and put it into a container. So next, what I'm going to do is basically any of my seedlings that are not they're dead, I'm just going to empty the soil out into my potting mix here. Okay, so all of these, the seedlings have died, so I'm basically just going to empty the contents out. The next thing I need to do is get rid of these spent radishes, and I'm gonna feed them to the worms in the new worm bin on the side garden. So let's do that. All right, so here they are in here, and it's gone down quite a bit since I filled it. So they're definitely, there they are. They're definitely working. So I'll feed them with some radishes. And I think I need to bring out some more newspaper and cover them up. But yeah, that's it. Alright, so the next thing I need to do is I need to sow the cilantro microgreens. These have been sprouting since last Tuesday. And I started them later than I should have, but I'm getting some good germination on these. This is my second time sprouting cilantro, so everything looks good. So all I need to do is basically get my trays, which are already cleaned and sanitized, fill them with the soil, water, and then put the seeds, stack, and then that's it. So I'll show you guys what that process looks like. Alright, so here are my clean trays here, so I'm just going to grab them and around, separate them out. Some of them are cracked, so what I'll do is I'll double them up. This is the mix that I use. I use Pro Mix with mycorrhizae, and then I also use some organic peat moss. I don't mix the two together. Each are used for different microgreens. So I use the organic peat moss for my organic seeds, and then I use the Pro Mix for my conventional seeds. What I do to make it a little bit faster for me is I just have it already like broken up in a tote, and so I can just like transfer it pretty easy into my trays. So I take 1 quart and about a half per flat, per 10 by 20 flat. Alright, so I spread out all of the sprouted seeds. All I do is now I'm just going through and making sure that there's no clumps and that everything is as even as possible. So they're just gonna sit in here stacked. I'm going to move them, but just for filming purposes, I just put them on top of this old cooler. And that's it. I'm just going to wait for them to get taller and then unstack them. Hey everybody, welcome back to the day 2 of this garden vlog. I wasn't able to finish everything yesterday because I needed to get my microgreens going and I just needed to like focus in on that. I did seed the cilantro like you've seen earlier in this video, but I also did the rest of my weekly microgreens I grow, like buckwheat, amaranth, broccoli, spicy salad mix, and 3 different types of radishes. So yeah, it's been raining pretty much all morning here. Today is December 4th, I believe. So yeah, I'll show you how I need to take care of my stuff when it's raining and how I just take measures. It's not really drastic. I basically just drape plastic over everything, so I'll show you guys. Alright, so this is my main work area where I wash and do all that stuff and keep extra things, glass, mason jars, totes. So I just drape plastic over this because it is exposed here. And I just want to keep everything nice and dry. And that is where I keep my microgreen seeds on one of these shelves. Then I do remove my cushions here, not the ones in the bottom, but I remove the top ones so they don't get like completely just messed up by the rain. Sunflowers all covered up. Look at the scarlet runner beans are doing great. They're making their way all the way up. I even see a flower here, which is pretty cool. It does need some fertilizer though. And the mint is behind me. I don't know if you guys are interested in seeing how I do these mint cuttings. It's super easy. I just recently got into this. So yeah. All right, so this is basically just how I cover up my microgreens. It's very simple. I just, you know, put this plastic, I just latch it up on top with some of those clamps. Nothing fancy. This is a cilantro, which might be ready for me to take this week. I'm not sure. We'll see. Same thing with over here with this second shelf. That's all microgreens, just covered up. And then these are all microgreens. They just needed to be covered. Because you could see here, this water kind of pulls up. We've been getting a lot of rain lately, and that one was exposed, which wasn't supposed to be. So I'm just gonna tip that off. And then these are all covered. Those are sunflower microgreens inside. Let's take a little peek. They're doing good. They're doing really good. There's Beck there being a little brat. And then, yeah, those are, I just pulled out my greenhouse covers so that I can cover up my my greenhouse shelves. These are mini greenhouses. This one, and this one. So they all now have their plastic on them, which were stored away during the summer months. And actually today I need to dig out the compost. This is the perfect time for me to dig out the compost because it's not hot at all. So I'm just gonna grab a bucket, and it's sprinkling, so I'm not really sure if I'm gonna do that right now. But yeah, everything's doing great. The oranges, since I've showed you guys in the last garden tour, are really ripening up. Looks great. All right, so here's a little tip for you guys. Now, this is cold and flu season, and I like to kind of get my immune system ready for that, and I do take echinacea. I take two of these capsules every morning. It says, I think, one to take, but I take two. And this stuff is great. It has the vegetarian capsules, so it's like not plastic or anything. And yeah, this stuff is great. Alright, so I finished up at the hydroponic store. They gave me some free stickers, which is really cool. And then I got my flats, 10 by 20 flats with holes. So I got 8 of them for, I think it was like $10. So they always give me a really good deal. I have an account with them, so they pretty much hook it up. But as I'm getting into the car, my car battery is dead. So I gotta wait for somebody to come help me right now. So just basically sitting here until I can leave. So yeah, I don't know. Let me know what you guys are doing in your gardens. I'll probably edit this vlog while I sit here. But yeah, I like this bag that I have. It's called Plant Lady for Life. Yeah, that was really weird about my car, because when I turned it on this morning, I heard a weird sound, but it didn't sound like the battery. But I know that if it rains a lot, like, it can mess, if the water gets underneath the hood, it can start messing with, like, plugs and things like that, so that might have been what happened. I'm
not sure, but I have help on the way, so I'm not tripping too much.
All right, so I've made it back from the parking lot of the hydroponic store, and I've got my setup here for the composter to start digging out compost. It's very simple. All I need is a shovel and a bucket or something to put the finished compost in. I'll show you guys. Okay, so this is the only tool I need to dig. If I don't like this shovel, I can use something else, but I like this one because it's a little bit more narrow. Now, if it was like more spade-like, that would be even better. But I like this one because it's narrow and the hole in here is not that big, so for me to dig out the compost, so I like that. And then this is just the container that I'll be using to put the finished compost in. So that's it. Here's what the compost is looking like, which is really good. This stuff's like so broken down. A lot of this is the, I would say 95% of this is the microgreen mix, the spent micro mix. So I haven't tried reusing this, but I'm just a little scared to reuse it for the microgreens, but I don't have any problem reusing it for the vegetable beds. They really like it. So that's how it looks inside. There, it's like a little compost cave. I'm just gonna put my hand in there. It's not as hot actually as it probably should be, but it's also not as wet. You can see it's really dry at the bottom. It should be a lot wetter than this, actually. So I'm just gonna keep digging. Whew, I'm out of breath. All right, so I almost filled this full container up. I would say that's maybe 3 or 4 cubic feet of soil compost ready to go. So what I'm going to do now is basically, I'll show you guys, because a lot of people, they might not know what to do after you dig out the compost. So I'll show you right now. I'm out of breath. Digging compost is a good exercise. So that's basically it. I don't recommend you guys standing on your compost like that. I do that just because I trust myself, and I know that, like, it's me if I fall, you know. So you guys take care of your compost pile at your own risk. But yeah. Basically, if you have like a compost pile going that's not enclosed like I do, you don't really have to worry about that. You can just turn it, but I can't really turn it in here, so I have to dig stuff out from the bottom and make sure it falls down to the bottom. So yeah. That's a chore I never look forward to doing, but it has to be done. I might close out this garden vlog right now. So yeah. The rain is actually starting to pick up. You might be able to hear it, I'm not sure. But yeah, thank you guys for watching this garden vlog. If you have any questions about anything I was doing or, you know, microgreens or whatever, let me know in the comments down below. Go ahead and subscribe. The rain's picking up, so I gotta go. Bye, happy gardening, everyone.